What did you get for number two on the biology homework?
Do you think I did the biology homework? Sorry, I can't help you.
Fuck, here they go again.
Did they rehearse this?
I'm not even sure. Like, how are they all dancing in sync and harmonizing?
Yeah, like, did we miss something or...
Wait,
aren't they...
Siblings? Yeah. Okay, now I'm just confused.
Yeah, why are they all up on each other like that?
This school is so fucking weird. Also, do you think they do, like, weird shit together behind closed doors? Dumb.
What is going on? I don't know.
When did they even rehearse this?
Are we just not getting invited to rehearsals?
How are they all singing the same words?
This literally makes no fucking sense.
I told my mom she shouldn't transfer me here, but no.
Me fucking too.
I don't know why my mom forced me to come to this weird ass summer camp.
I know, it literally makes no sense.
Are they really singing right now?
When did Ryan get in the pool?
Is he wearing a suit?
When the fuck did he even have time to change?
Why is he fully clothed in the pool?
No, now I'm really confused.
Why?
Chad is saying, I don't dance, but he's literally singing and dancing. I don't dance,
no. Yeah, that's kind of hypocritical.
Do you think he understands that he just can't say, I don't dance, and then be dancing on a baseball field?
He's literally proving Ryan right.
Also, what's the big deal with guys dancing?
Talk about toxic masculinity.
I know! So, like, is anyone actually gonna do their job here, or are we gonna be the only people putting in any work?
Yeah, this is ridiculous.
Holy shit.
What is it?
I think Gabriella's drowning.
What do you mean?
Look! Are any of you gonna do something?
Anyone gonna help her?
Someone help her!
You're all so fucking sick and twisted.
Children these days are just not as nice as they used to be. Kids used to know how to be polite and respect their elders. Now, they're just rude.
Como dices que es porque you're all fucking idiots?
You expect the younger generation to actually respect you when you're more concerned with banning a social media app than you are with the school shootings happening in this country?
Congress literally held over a 5-hour hearing, making fools out of themselves,
and asking the most absurd questions to TikTok's CEO,
all because they want to ban TikTok because they think TikTok is dangerous.
Yet, we're all still waiting for you to ban the weapons that are literally taking children's lives in this country.
You want to talk about dangerous? Why don't we talk about that?
Because unlike the fools you made out of yourselves at that hearing, there's actually proof as to why you should ban the weapons that you still sell to civilians in this country, or even add stricter laws around them. But you're more concerned with deleting a social media app. Whew, that's crazy, bitch.
So, I genuinely thought I was gonna die today, and this video might get a hit put out on me, so, if I end up dead and my body is found in the Hudson River, just know I would
never
harm myself.
Hi, everyone, if you're new, welcome!
If you're not new, you know.
Fuck-ass time it is, bitch! It's time for the fuck-ass daily scream, so get in your fucking seats!
So today I was on a walk with one of my friends and I wanted to get coffee. All I'm gonna say is the place where I chose to get coffee was in fact not a coffee shop. I walked into this place, it had no windows. And the first thing me and my friends saw when we walked in were tables full of men, and all of them snapped their heads and looked at us the second we walked in. So we both end up walking up to the counter so we can order some coffee. And when I looked at the person behind the register and was like, oh, can I just get an iced coffee? The person was like,
ice and coffee?
And I was like, yes, please. Next thing I know, the person behind the register is handing me my coffee. Mind you, from the moment I stepped in with my friend to the moment I left, the men sitting at the tables would not stop looking at us. And as I'm taking out my wallet to pay for this coffee, the person behind the counter looks at me and whispers to me,
go. Quickly, leave.
I don't know what I was interrupting or what I walked into with my friend, but I know for damn well it was not a coffee shop.
Mr. Chu, does TikTok access the home Wi-Fi network?
Only if the user turns on the Wi-Fi.
So if I have a TikTok app on my phone and my phone is on my home Wi-Fi network, does TikTok access that network?
The only face data that you get, that we collect, is when you use the filters to have, say, sunglasses on your face. We need to know where your eyes are.
And why do you need to know what the eyes are if you're not seeing if they're dilated?
And those were two prime examples of people that help run the U.S. government.
We are so screwed. This country is so screwed. Oh, my God.
Guess who almost got hit by a car?
Honestly, I should have just let it happen. Because either way, the bitch would have taken me out of my misery, or I'd have a pretty little lawsuit on my hands. But yeah, if you couldn't put two and two together,
it was me! I was almost hit by a car!
Hey everyone, if you're new, welcome!
If you're not, you know,
fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the fucking Daily Scream, oh my god! Ever since being home, I've missed going on my nightly runs. So yesterday, I decided to go on a run. Here are a few cute pics. Anyways, while I was on my run, I ran past a parking lot. One side of the parking lot was the entrance and the other side was the exit. Lo and behold, as I'm passing the exit side of the parking lot, there was a woman sitting in her car waiting to turn. Now, the road wasn't busy, so I just stood there and did one of those jog-in-place things. Like this! But the bitch wouldn't go, so I was like, oh, maybe she's letting me go. And then as I'm about to run in front of her car,
the bitch hit the gas!
So I jump back, the woman looks at me, I tell her to go, and she ends up reversing. So naturally, I thought the bitch was letting me go. I then tried to run past her car again, and the bitch hit her gas again! At this point, I felt like a squirrel in the middle of traffic dodging cars, because it literally looked like this. And then this lady ends up rolling down her window and yelling at me, and she's like,
do you have a death wish?
Which I then replied, do you know how to fucking drive? Just go! For someone who almost hit me and had a lawsuit on their hands, you're acting very bold. I fucking hate people. Have any of you almost shit your pants in public? And no, I'm being serious. I don't mean like, oh my god, I almost shit my pants. I mean like booty clenched, hands on your ass, 3 miles away from home, no car, hoping you make it home in time before you shit your pants on the side of the road. And if you guys are like, wow, that's really specific. Yeah, I know, because that was me
last night I decided to go on
one of my nightly runs, and I don't know what made me be like, we're running 6 miles tonight, but I ended up running 3 miles away from my house, so I had to go 3 miles back home. Holy shit, bitch, like literally. I hit that 3 mile marker, I turned around, I was jogging, and I was like, wait, we gotta stop now! I ate pasta and a sandwich yesterday before my run. I recommend that if you decide to go on a run, you make sure that your stomach settles instead of just going straight into the run, because guess what I found out? Running actually stimulates gastric mobility. I found that out today, actually, look! So like if you're running or jogging or walking, that causes you to need to shit. I don't know how I made it home, but it was not. Oh my god. If you saw me on the sidewalk yesterday, booty clenched with my hands on my ass, no, you
fucking didn't.
We all have really low points in our life, and last night was beyond low for me. In case you didn't know, there was another school shooting today that happened in Nashville, Tennessee. 6 people died today, and among those 6, 3 of them were children. Firstly, we saw women's reproductive rights get stripped away in this country. Then we saw states taking away the rights of LGBTQIA performers from performing in public spaces because they find drag queens too dangerous. And now we're seeing Congress having over 5-hour-long hearings to talk about how dangerous TikTok is and how it's harming the children in this country. You want to know what's actually harming the children in this country? Automatic assault weaponry. But have we seen a ban on those? Have we seen stricter laws that have actually benefited the people in this country? There are children and teenagers younger than me that can already see the underlying problems that we have in this country. Either the people who run our government are too stupid to actually see the real fucking problems, or they're too afraid to lose funding from the NRA to actually do anything about it, because God forbid, lo and behold, you banned women's reproductive rights because you care so much about unborn fetuses. What about the children who are already alive and afraid to go to school? What about the children's lives we lose in schools every other week because of these automatic assault weapons? Oh, no fucking answer. That's what I thought.
There are things that can make someone hot, but someone's vibe will make them cuter.
Sex with me, so amazing. All this hard work, no vacation. Stay up off my Instagram, your temptation. Hit a switch on a fake.
Ditch this with the gayest thing you've ever done.
The gayest thing I've ever done is probably, sucked it. Is it illegal for your pharmacist to lie to you? Because I feel like it's illegal. Okay, so it's actually not illegal, but it fucking should be! So I haven't had my ADHD medication, Adderall, in almost a fucking week. Now, I personally don't mind, but the withdrawals are kicking my fucking ass. Anyways, I call my pharmacist today and I'm like,
hey girl, where's that Adderall prescription?
And she was like,
no worries, it's arriving to your house today, no later than 12 p.m.
Bitch, guess what time it is?
19 p.m.
I still don't have my fucking prescription. So I ended up calling my pharmacy again. Someone new answers the phone. And I was like,
hey girl, where's my order? Someone told me to be here by 12 p.m. today and it's not here.
You know what the new pharmacist said to me on the phone?
I don't know why they told you it was coming today, because it says in our system it's arriving by 5 p.m. tomorrow. I guess she assumed to be having mood swings, so she lied to you so you wouldn't get angry at her and yell on the phone.
What? angry? I mean, I wasn't angry before.
But now I'm fucking angry!
Bitch, buckle up, because what am I about to tell you?
So about a week ago, I called my pharmacy to place an at-home delivery. Now, when I spoke to them, I gave them my mom's address because I'm currently not in California, but I specifically told this bitch on the phone!
If my medication can't get here before the 31st, is it possible for you to send it to the California address you have on file?
The woman on the phone then reassured me and told me I would have my medication
yesterday!
When my medication didn't arrive yesterday, I then called the pharmacy again, and the woman on the phone then reassured me that I would have my medication before I left for California.
Shocker! It never fucking came!
So I ended up calling back yesterday and I was like,
hey girl, where the fuck are my meds?
And the woman on the phone was like,
it's actually not gonna arrive until tomorrow.
And as I mentioned previously, I was like,
are you positive? Because if my medication isn't here before the 31st, then I won't have my medication for a month.
This bitch then reassured me and said, no, you'll have your medication tomorrow. Last night rolls around and I'm checking my order status. Guess when my meds are coming?
The 30 fucking first!
Go to part two. Anyways, I'm on my 12th fucking pharmacy representative and I'm telling her all my issues. And I was like,
listen, babe, I know it's not your fault, but I specifically said that if I can't get my medication before the 31st, I need it shipped to California.
And she was like,
don't worry, sweetie, I completely understand. I'll set everything up for you. I'll call USPS and have them send your medication to the California address.
I literally was like, oh my god, thank you, you're a saint!
Lo and behold, I checked my order status about a fucking hour ago.
And it's still shipping to my mom's address!
So I call again!
And I'm talking to a new fucking representative!
And she goes,
I don't know why the woman told you yesterday that she could call USPS and change the address. You have to do that yourself.
Bitch, are you all fucking dead?
Who the fuck hired you?
So I called USPS. I'm on the phone for like 30 fucking minutes. Some random guy answers the phone and I was like, hey, I'd like to change the address of one of my packages. This man goes,
I don't understand.
And hung up the phone.
I want to know who's in charge of hiring phone call representatives, because bitch, when I find you,
I'll show you who fucking tough.
In case you guys didn't know, I am currently going through withdrawals. Now you might be asking yourself, what the fuck are you withdrawing from, Spencer? That's an amazing question. And the answer is,
Adderall!
I finally managed to talk to a mentally sound person on the phone after being transferred 15 times between different fucking pharmacist
representatives.
And it turns out there's actually no way for me to get my medication shipped to my California address.
Woo!
I feel kind of bad though, because at one point I did tell the representative on the phone,
I know this isn't your fault, but I keep hearing different answers from different people and I'm just curious, do any of you actually know what you're talking about?
And then the phone went silent because the pharmacist
hung up.
And because I'm going through withdrawals, I'd like to share a few of them with you. Depression, a hard time sleeping, fatigue, nausea, stomach aches or cramping, vomiting. Now I want you all to guess, out of all of these symptoms, which ones I've been experiencing.
Fucking all of them!
This is how I feel.
Guess what I have, bitches?
My Adderall!
Takes me how to death, takes me, takes me how to death.
That's right, bitches, I got my meds! I feel
fantastic!
I mean, it did almost take a week and a fucking half
for my meds to get to me. But now that they're here, I no longer feel like a crack addict. Also, guys, because I didn't have my Adderall, I was a bit constipated. I popped one of those puppies down my throat this morning with a little bit of water, and bam! I was in the bathroom. My stomach feels better. I feel better. Today's just so good!
You know, the more I talk about Adderall, the more I realize that I might actually be addicted to it. But technically, hear me out, because it helps me in my day-to-day life and it actually helps me get shit done, I guess the whole addiction part is like canceled out.
I know, you fucking lying bitch.
You know, it doesn't seem that bad in here. I agree. I don't know why these bitches are acting so scared. Bestie, what is it? I think I know why we got called in.
Oh shit,
punch it, punch that bitch back.
She can't see it.
Just start swinging at the air.
It just got really cold in here.
Wait, do you see that?
I don't see anything. Where?
There.
Girl, why are you screaming?
Do you not see the demon?
Where?
There.
Two claps. Two more claps.
Wanna play hide and clap?
Stop pranking me. You can't make me come out of my hiding spot that easily.
Bitch, help me.
Nice try, bitch, but you can't fool me.
Hey, Lucifer.
Or should we call you Satan?
What?
Is my ex down here?
Yeah, because if he isn't, I'm gonna be shocked.
Now, that would be fucked. If we were down here and he was all the way up in heaven.
What's his name?
Jason Lockwood.
Oh, yeah, he's here. He's a piece of shit.
I fucking knew it.
Okay, bestie, we're close. Just a few more steps.
I can't wait to get the fuck out of here.
Shh. We're almost there!
Thank God!
Hey!
Where do you two think you're going?
You couldn't have celebrated after we made it into heaven!
Sorry.
This is the 12th time this week you two have decided to try to sneak into heaven!
It was his idea!
Bitch!
Sorry, I panicked.
You are both tasked with giving the gargoyles manicures for the next century!
You wanna know who actually deserves to do this?
Who?
My ex. Yeah, if you want a real piece of shit doing hard work, let it be him, not us.
Okay.
Really?
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. Chasing after you two while you try to escape has been the most fun I've had in years.
Okay, go! Ow. Ow. Ow.
Okay, guys, I just landed at LAX. I'm finally back in California. You can stop pranking me now. Where's the paparazzi? I've been here for 5 minutes and I haven't been swarmed by flashing lights, cameras, and interview questions. I'm a little confused. Like Hollywood Fix, where are you? So no one? Okay.
He wants to marry me.
I'm getting my Adderall, bitches! No, but I'm actually dead serious this time. I should have it by tomorrow. So this morning I got a text from my mom and she basically just told me that the post office was able to intercept my package and then she was able to ship it to me to California. But here's the
fucking kicker.
Even though my medication was sent to my mom's address in New Jersey, guess what address was on the package? I'll give you a minute to guess.
My California address!
So that entire time, the address on the package was the same address I told the pharmacist representatives to send to
a billion fucking times!
But it still went to New Jersey. Bitch, what? Anyways, I'll have my meds by tomorrow, so I hopefully won't be feeling like this anymore. And for anyone who's like, but what if your meds don't come tomorrow? Bitch, there is no what if! I am getting my meds tomorrow.
Oh my fucking God.
What?
Derek's friend just sent me a video of him making out with some other girl.
Are you fucking serious?
Yes, look. I'll be right back. Where are you going?
You'll see.
Where the fuck did you get a ski mask and a trench coat?
There are certain things that are better left unsaid.
A few minutes later.
Bestie, where the fuck did you go?
I'm back, bitch.
Where have you been?
A few places.
Which ones?
I met up with one of my associates who has ties to the black market to see how much we could get for selling one of your ex's kidneys. And when he ended up telling me he couldn't get us anything higher than 20 grand, I went to the next place.
You can't be serious.
Oh, but I am. I then went to his parents' house and I convinced them that I was a doctor and their son have contracted 3 STIs.
What did they say? His parents are like crazy Christians.
Oh, I'll get to that. After I convinced them that their son was a little whore, they ended up calling him back home and then they called a priest to perform an exorcism, which they're doing on him right now. I then went to his car, slashed his tires, and released a king cobra in his backseat.
You're fucking crazy.
I know.
Wanna watch a movie?
Duh, bitch.
Whoever made like dating app voice prompts a thing, I need you to get rid of them. I need you to get rid of them now. I just saw a guy. I don't even know if I can bring myself to say this. It is so, I'm gonna cry. Oh my God. Some guy, like, I guess, like, swiped right on me. And on the app I use, I can see who likes me. So I went to his profile and he looked kind of cute, but then I heard his voice prompt and he was like, ah! And the prompt was like, what's it like dating you? And he was like, well, I'm bi and I'm poly. So, a lot of fun.
No!
Oh my God. Like, no. Who let you upload that? Your friends are not your real friends. If your friends saw that on your fucking profile and they were like, yeah, that's good. Bitch, you need to stop being friends with them right now. Cause that was That was the most sick and deranged thing. No, please take it down.
Hey, I think you should ban the weapons that are taking the lives of the youth in this country.
No, the weapons aren't the problem. It's the people that are purchasing them.
Okay, so have you thought about passing stricter laws that would prevent those weapons from landing in the wrong hands?
Well, we've actually come up with a few laws to help protect the children in this country.
Okay, let's hear them.
Ban TikTok.
Okay, so I actually think you completely missed the entire point about the whole weapon.
Also ban abortion.
We're all kind of confused as to how you think that's gonna help this country in any way.
We also plan to ban drag shows in public spaces and put an end to sex, gender, and racial studies.
We really think you're missing the point here.
Oh yeah, and lastly, we plan to approve the Willow Project, which will seemingly continue to destroy the environment and probably leave all of you without a livable planet within the next 50 years.
Okay, but like, what about the future children that are then going to have to try to live in an unlivable environment?
I mean, we won't be here within the next 50 years, so that seems like something you guys have to figure out on your own.
Oh, okay, yeah, so you're just all fucking stupid. Got it.
Guys, I don't know if I can keep doing this anymore. Every day I open this app and it's just like someone new is saying something terrible about me. You know, I do try to not let it get to me, but recently I just can't help it. I just think it would be best if I deleted TikTok for a while.
Psych, bitch! Happy April Fools!
You think some bitch sitting behind a screen with no profile picture is actually gonna hurt my feelings? I do a better job at tearing myself down every single day than half of you bitches could even attempt to do in a lifetime.
It's no surprise to me, I am my own worst enemy.
So as many of you know, I went back home to New Jersey to visit family. Now, I was in New Jersey for about 2 weeks, and while I was there, I was like,
hey, we've been going to the gym in California pretty consistently. We should keep it up in New Jersey.
So the first night I was in New Jersey, I actually went to a gym and signed up for a monthly membership. I want you all to guess how many times I went to the gym while I was in New Jersey. I went 3 fucking times. I literally was hyping myself up too. I was like, oh my gosh, we got a gym membership. We're gonna go every single day while we're here.
Nope.
Anyways, at the gym I went to, you had to cancel your gym membership in person. So before I flew back to California, I had to go back to the gym in person to cancel that monthly charge. Bitch, I went in there and I was like,
hey, I'm here to cancel my membership.
The guy then looked at my profile and he was like,
are you sure?
And I was like, yeah, why? And he goes,
well, it says here that you've only had this membership for 2 weeks and you've only been here 3 times.
I was baffled.
The woman was too stunned to speak.
And I was like, well, I live in California and I have a gym membership out there, so we're all good. This man then looked me up and down and said,
sure.
I'm never showing my face there again. Recently, my entire comment section has been filled with this. Spencer, the boss. Spencer, do something about the bots. Spencer, why are there so many bots in this comment section?
Bitch, what do you want me to do?
I can't control the bots in my comment section. And we all know they're bots because all of their accounts look like this. I understand and I know that the bots in my comment section are out of control. But not only are they out of control, they're out of my control. Bitch, do you think I'm some Disney Channel hacker that can access the mainframe of TikTok and send all these bots away? I can't. I can't send these bitches away and I'm sorry. So for now, you, me, and the rest of Spencewell Parliament, we're all just gonna have to
put up with it, bitch.
I think we need to talk.
What's wrong?
I wanna break up.
What do you mean?
I'm just not happy with you anymore, and I've found someone else.
Who?
Me. I'm sorry, bestie.
What are you two talking about?
Remember when you went away that one weekend for a family trip?
Mm-hmm.
And you asked us to look after your apartment while you were gone?
Yeah.
Well, we kind of started talking, and at first it was nothing, but now we're together.
Are you kidding me? What is wrong with you two?
I swear to God, I'm just gonna... Bestie, hello?
There's no pulse.
Oh my fucking God, what did you do? We were just doing an April Fool's prank on you.
Wait, so you guys aren't together?
No, we were just doing an April Fool's prank on you. We didn't know you would take it this far.
I can't have you going around telling people what I did.
I won't tell anyone, I swear.
I can't trust you, I'm sorry.
What are you doing?
April Fool's!
What the fuck?
Did you really think after telling me you wanted to prank my bestie, I wouldn't turn around, tell my bestie about the prank that you planned, and then plan another prank to prank you?
You two are sick.
We know. Bitch.
I fucking hate
taxes!
You mean to tell me the government knows exactly how much I owe, but they just refuse to tell me
how much I fucking owe?
And if I do the math wrong and I underpay the government, I can be charged, fined, or sent away to prison? Something about this doesn't seem right. Why can't the government just send me a pretty yellow envelope that says, hey, this is what you owe us?
But no!
Do you know how much fucking easier that would be? Instead, though, I either have to hire an accountant to do my taxes for me, or I have to be an accountant and do my taxes myself. Bitch, I don't know how to do that. At this point, lock me up and send me to Alcatraz, because the amount of rattling my brain has done to try to wrap my head around fucking taxes, bitch, I think I have fucking whiplash now.
So as many of you know, Demi Lovato released a rock version of their song, Heart Attack. And after hearing the rock version, I was moved. So now I would like to do an impression of myself singing La La Land by Demi Lovato, but in rock version. Before I get started, I'm gonna have to request that all of you imagine that there's a band behind me, because if you don't, I'm gonna look really stupid. So imagine that there's like an electric guitarist, a bassist, a drummer, like all behind me. I'm at the mic and this is my rock version of La La Land.
Because of where I had my started, where I made my name, well, everything's the same in the La La Land.
But imagine it with like a band and it's like 10 times better.
So I've discovered something about myself recently that might cause a vast majority of you to lose respect for me. I was talking to one of my friends the other day and we ended up on the topic of Lunchables.
Lunchables, lunch your tummy right.
If you don't know what Lunchables are, you were stripped of a vital childhood experience. Anywho, while we were talking about Lunchables, we ended up on the subtopic of Lunchable varieties. Now I've never once thought to myself that I eat Lunchables in a weird way until me and my friend landed on the Lunchables sandwich variety. My friends started telling me that when they eat that specific Lunchable,
Lunchable.
They
actually
make the sandwich with the Ritz cracker, meat, and cheese. I, however, did not know that it was uncommon to eat all the ingredients separately. But when I told my friend that I eat the sandwich Lunchables like a charcuterie board, he looked at me like I committed a crime. Look, I just feel like it's wrong for people to judge me and shame me based off of the way I eat my fucking Lunchables. So if you have a problem with it,
kick rocks, bitch!
Look, I don't know if the Instagram employee who had the bright idea of allowing Instagram users to buy their verification check marks, but whoever it was that thought of the idea and actually followed through with it,
you need to be fired.
I'm not verified on Instagram, and I've been trying to get verified for a while now. I've sent in emails, I've sent in my verification requirements. I've gone the whole nine yards, bitch. But if you think for a fucking second, I am paying $12 a month for an Instagram blue checkmark?
Hell fucking no!
You want me to pay $12 a month for a blue verification checkmark?
Not on my watch!
I'm sorry, but absolutely the fuck not.
Okay, what do you think of this picture?
Oh my fucking gosh, you look so cute!
I know, right? Do you think you can help me with like a caption or something? Wait, do you think Mr. Abbott is trying to tell us something?
I don't know. He seems pretty far away. Let me just call him.
We just have to be really quiet. The creatures are almost gone. Sorry, one sec.
Hey girl, what's up? Nothing. We're just hiding from those scary monsters.
Bestie! The phone down.
No way.
Shh, shut the fuck up.
Wait, you know what? Give me a sec. Bestie, I love you, but I'm trying to have a conversation. Can you just please keep it down?
Shut the fuck up.
What the hell?
Bitch, you know what? What do you want?
I feel like duct taping my mouth is a little unnecessary.
Girl, I love you, but you don't know how to shut the fuck up.
But my therapist told me I should step out of my comfort zone and be more vocal.
Your therapist is dead, and we will be too if you don't learn how to stop fucking speaking.
Point taken.
I need all of you to know that the author who wrote this, the author of this book, you're sick. You are so sick. You are so sick. Why would you do this to me?
The bitch who wrote this book,
V.E. Schwab, you need to be, what's your full fucking name? Victoria V.E. Schwab, you need to be locked away. Why would you end the book that way? I don't want to show my face. I'm embarrassed. Well, why the fuck would you end the book this way?
What's wrong?
I'm fine.
Okay.
Bitch, have you lost your damn mind?
What are you doing here?
Bitch, I've been here.
No, you haven't.
Yes, I have. I've been playing my Nintendo Switch under the kitchen sink.
Why the fuck were you underneath the sink?
Better question, why the fuck are you so stupid?
What do you mean?
When she says, I'm fine, that means she's not fine and you probably did something to piss her off.
Well, how am I supposed to know if she didn't tell me I did something?
She did tell you though.
When?
When she said, I'm fine, she told you everything right there.
But saying I'm fine literally means I'm okay.
By definition, you're correct, but in this circumstance, you're wrong!
How?
You need to read the context clues. When she said, I'm fine, she didn't sound like she actually meant it.
Is that kind of like when she says, I'm not hungry, and then when I go get food, she eats all of mine?
Precisely!
Oh!
I see my work here is done.
Everybody know them Oakland hoes is red flags. Y'all be thinking that I'm joking, but I'm dead ass.
But if you really are one dumb, ugly bitch, huh? Mm-hmm. Bitch, how the fuck do you sound and look stupid? Pick a struggle, you weird ass, dumb ass bitch.
You wanna tell me to pick a struggle? Bitch, how about you help me pick which tooth I'm gonna knock out of your fucking head first?
All right, extraterrestrials. If you're real, it's about damn time you came out of hiding.
It's about damn time.
The world is turning to absolute shit. And I know you're out there. We've got Area 51. We've seen UFO clips online. I just feel like the human race could use some help from an advanced civilization. Unless you guys are coming here for like salvation, then this planet is definitely the wrong planet to go to. Also, if you guys decide to take humans off of Earth and abduct us, I'd like to speak on behalf of myself when I say this.
Please take me, bitch!
Take me fucking with you!
I promise I won't be a burden. I'll clean up after you guys. I'll help you with whatever you need help with. You need a sample of human blood to correctly decode our DNA? Bitch, I know where all my good veins are.
Just please, if you're fucking out there, either help us or take me with you, because I don't know if I can keep doing this much longer. Please answer.
Hey, what's up?
I don't know what to do anymore.
About what?
Heather won't stop talking shit about me. Like, I dread going to school every single fucking
day. One second, bestie. Do you mind staying on the phone with me while I go do something really quick?
Yeah, sure. Where the fuck are you going?
Hey, Heather!
What the fuck are you doing in my house?
The next time you want to talk shit about my bestie, remember this moment. Stop talking shit about my
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
All done.
What did you just do?
I went to Heather's house and put that bitch in her place.
What if she runs to the principal's office and tells the principal what you did?
She won't.
How do you know?
Because she knows I know where she lives. Now, is anyone else bothering you?
No.
Okay, well, if someone does bother you, let me know. Love you, bestie.
I love you too.
Okay, I think I'm ready to go out now.
Why don't you wear the jeans I bought you?
I would, but I don't really fit in them right now.
I mean, I told you looked like you were putting on some weight.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means you should probably start going to the gym.
Bestie, can I smack him?
Come on, you're not actually gonna smack. What was that for?
Let me tell you a little secret, okay? Women put up with enough shit from men, and the last thing they want to worry about is a douchebag like you commenting on their weight.
I wasn't trying to be mean.
But when I shove my fist so far up your ass you can taste my knuckles on the back of your throat, just know that I also wasn't trying to be mean.
Okay.
Now apologize to my bestie.
I'm sorry, babe. I wasn't trying to insult you. I think you're beautiful just the way you are.
Now, before I leave, let me make one thing fucking clear, okay? If I ever hear you make another negative comment about my bestie's weight again, I will kidnap you in your sleep, put your sleepy body in a barrel, and then push that barrel off the side of a fucking cliff with you inside of it. Now, both of you have a great rest of your day.
I love you, bitch.
Do you guys understand how annoying it is?
Being a fucking bottom?
Like, don't get me wrong. I understand why girls get upset when they've spent all night getting ready just for the guy to cancel on their late night fun endeavors. But do you understand how annoying that is when it happens to a bottom? Not only do some of us shave, but we have to make sure that we're really clean down there. And that's not easy. We have to take a bulb full of water, shove it up there, and then spray the water around to make sure that we're all clean. Then after letting the water sit in there, we gotta let it all out, rinse, and repeat. And sometimes water comes out clear after the third try. And sometimes you're on your seventh try and it's still not coming out fucking clear. And then by the grace of God, finally, the water comes out clear. You're ready to go. And then you get a text that says,
"Hey, so sorry, but can we do a rain check?"
You mean to tell me this entire time I could have been eating Taco Bell, but instead I was living out World War III in my bathroom getting ready for something that isn't even gonna fucking happen?
What gives you the impression that I had a rough night? No, I didn't. I feel fine. I feel perfectly fine.
I feel like maybe I should stop drinking. Not for my own well-being, but for everybody else's sake. I don't know at what point last night I went from a fun party girl to an MMA fighting champion, but I did put my friend in a chokehold several times. I don't really know what overcomes me either. Like, it kind of just happens on its own. Now, I'm not saying that when I drink, I get the uncontrollable urge to put people in a chokehold.
I know, you fucking lying bitch!
I'm just trying to say, when I drink, it's really hard for me to not control that urge.
Call the police.
Anyways, I woke up this morning to a 2-minute voicemail from one of my friends, and I guess while I had him in a chokehold in my apartment last night, he accidentally called me, because when I woke up, this is what I heard.
What is it? It's fucking me up.
I have this. I would just like to say, if you saw me last night...
No, you didn't.
I don't support putting people in chokeholds, and you shouldn't either. I'm Spenswa, and I approve this message.
I think I have a crush on Luigi.
Oh, thank you.
Damn it. What's wrong? When we went out last night, I met this really cute guy. We talked for like an hour, but I only know his first name, and I can't find him on any social media.
Do you know what he looks like?
Yeah.
Okay, one sec.
What are you doing?
I need you to tell me everything you remember about him.
Okay. His name was John.
Mm-hmm.
He was a good like 5'10".
Mm-hmm.
He had blonde hair, green eyes, and I'm pretty sure he had a freckle on his upper lip.
Anything else?
Oh, yeah. He said he went to this Ivy League school, but I don't remember which one.
Okay.
There's no use. There's no way we're gonna find him.
Found him. His name is John Patricks. He goes to Brown University, and I also found all of his social media. Here you go.
Well, is it him?
Yeah, but how did you-
Shh. Don't ask questions you don't want answers to.
Should I DM him?
Duh!
Let me tell you something. I don't fuck with that bitch. Fuck that hoe.
You're kidding.
What is it?
All of our friends are hanging out without us.
So? We hang out without them all the time.
Yeah, but this is different. It's just the two of us hanging out versus all of them hanging out.
Well, what are we gonna do about it? We weren't invited and we can't just show up.
I mean, we can't show up, but we can make them jealous.
I think I know where you're going with this.
Do you still know how to edit videos?
Yes. Do you still know how to work a camera?
Yes.
Let's fucking do this.
Woo!
OMG, we're having so much fun!
This is so cool!
I can't believe we're partying at a real-life Hollywood mansion!
Are you done editing it yet?
Almost. And done!
Okay, let me see.
Woo! OMG, we're having so much fun! This is so cool! I can't believe we're partying at a real-life Hollywood mansion!
They're gonna be so fucking jealous.
Yeah, I know.
Dear Diary, it's now day 16 without Dick, and I'm starting to lose hearing in my left eye and taste in my right.
Oh! No, no, no! No, 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 no!
Come on, bitch. We have a problem.
What is it?
Remember that guy I was talking to?
Peter?
Yeah, him. He hasn't messaged me back in days, and I want to try to make him jealous.
Hello?
You called the right bitch!
What do we do?
Let me get changed real quick, and then I'll tell you the plan.
Okay.
20 minutes later.
Are you almost done?
Yeah, just give me one more sec. Okay, I'm done.
What are you doing?
Me and you are gonna take a picture so he thinks you're with a really manly hot guy when in reality you're just with me.
You're a fucking genius!
Okay, get your ass in here, take a cute selfie, and then put it on your Instagram story with some sexy music in the background. If I ran for president or government official, it would be for one reason and one reason only. World peace.
Fight, bitch!
I'm infiltrating the White House and I'm learning all of the juicy classified information. Now I know what you're all thinking.
But Spencer, if you were president, you can make this country a better place to live.
And yes, I agree with that sentiment. I mean, and obviously amongst many of my duties, one of my top priorities would be to make this country a safer and better place. But if I'm ever placed in the Oval Office, the first thing I'm doing is asking for the files. I'm gonna ask where Area 51 is, ask about the Illuminati. Ask if there are currently aliens on Earth in positions of power. Ask if there's a society within the inner Earth. And also ask if the men in black are real. And of course I'm gonna try to make this country a better place. However, as someone who grew up with the Mandela effect and a whole bunch of other conspiracy theories, can you blame me for wanting to know the entire
fucking truth?
Anyways, vote Spencer for president. I'm just so happy for everybody who got invited to Coachella this year. I couldn't be happier for all of the influencers who got invited and paid to go to one of the most famous music festivals in the country.
If you're at Coachella, I hope it thunderstorms and a torrential downpours on all of your fucking sorry asses.
Have fun! I am fucking humiliated! Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily Fucking Scream! So last night I went out with a few friends and we ended up seeing Cupcake perform live.
Help me! Fuck me!
Anyways, as we were leaving the venue where we saw Cupcake, I ran into this guy who was walking out with a whole bunch of security. And I was like, wait, I know who that is. So I turn around, look at my friends, and out loud I go, oh my god, guys, look, it's Adam Levine! Guys, it was in fact not Adam Levine. It was
Adam fucking Lambert!
Adam Lambert then turned around and said, who? Not Levine. Wrong one. And then his friends that were with him started laughing! But naturally, to deflect the attention elsewhere, I turned around, pointed at a security guard, and I was like,
yeah, why would you say that? That's clearly not Adam Levine.
The security guard then looked at me and said,
we all know it was you.
Bitch, I got in my Uber and never looked back.
You end up doing the laundry like I asked?
I'll get to it in a sec. Just let me finish my game.
But I told you to do the laundry yesterday. What am I gonna wear to work?
Wait, hold on. Yeah, guys.
Hey, bitch!
I marked over there. Yeah.
Can that bitch really not hear me? Instead?
Okay, I think that might
be. Bitch! Hey, we were about to win that game. Hand me back my controller. Yeah, well, I'm about to knock your two front teeth in if you don't shut the fuck up and listen up.
Give me a break.
Are you playing with friends?
Yeah.
Hey guys, I'm really sorry, but your friend has to leave. He has a terrible rash in places that I'd rather not say, but it'll be on tomorrow.
What the fuck?
Listen up, bitch. You are about as useless can be, and I've had it up to here. So here's what's gonna happen. You're gonna get up, you're gonna do the laundry you were supposed to do yesterday, and you're gonna clean up after all the shit that you leave around my bestie's apartment. And if I come back and I see the slightest mess anywhere, I will shove this controller so far up your ass you will taste the left and right trigger button.
Okay.
Now get to work.
Yes, ma'am.
You should be a drill sergeant.
You think?
No. I can't take it anymore!
I need to disappear. I need to fall off the face of the earth. If you guys didn't know, the other day I ran into
Adam Lambert!
Upon our meeting, I did in fact call Adam Lambert Adam Levine. And I posted a video about said interaction. What I wasn't expecting, however, was for Adam Lambert to not only see the video,
but post the video on his Instagram story!
Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! If you're not, you know,
second term it is, bitch!
It's time for the Daily Scream! Seeing myself screaming on Adam Lambert's story was just the icing on the cake.
Yummy!
I love how that was my first time meeting him, and that's all he has to remember me by! Adam, if you just so happen to see this video too... Hey, bestie! So sorry about accidentally calling you Adam Levine, and I hope we can both look past that brief yet horrendous interaction. Why you want for me? I really don't mean to sound like a shitty, horrible bitch, but hearing that a majority of the people who went to Coachella did not have a good time made me feel a lot better about not going. Like, don't get me wrong, I know a lot of people that actually enjoyed themselves while attending Coachella, but a vast majority of the shit I've seen online and a vast majority of the people I know that went to Coachella had like a horrible time, and I'm like really sorry about that, sorry. But while my friends were away at Coachella, I got to see Cupcake perform live. And by the way, when I say I saw Cupcake perform live, I mean I was so close to Cupcake, I could have touched her cheek. This is how close I was to Cupcake. I'm not even joking. I met Adam Lambert at a club. Also, everyone who didn't go to Coachella was out on the prowl this weekend. The clubs were so much fun and I made so many friends just simply because of the fact I didn't go to Coachella. And it's like, when all my friends went to Coachella, I was like, damn, I'm missing out. Turns out I think they were the ones missing out because I had an amazing weekend. Coachella! Do any of you happen to know what it feels like to have a barbell fall directly on your head while you're at the gym?
Oh, you don't?
Well, it fucking hurts like hell!
Guess who had a weighted barbell fall on top of their head at the gym today?
Don't worry, I'll give you time to guess.
Me, bitch! Hi, everyone, if you're new, welcome!
If you're not new, you know,
fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily Scream!
So today I went to the gym and worked out my legs because I want a fat, juicy,
voluptuous ass.
I'm thick as I beat an oat.
Anywho, this morning I wanted to start off with some basic squats, so I headed over to the barbell rack. Now, there are holders you use to place the barbell back down after you're done using it, and I must have been standing a little
too close to the fucking holders!
Because I went down for my first squat, and as I was going back up, I hit the bottom of the barbell holder, and then my barbell quite literally fell on the back of my
fucking head!
Now, was that painful? Yes, it was. But not as painful as the looks that I got while crawling up off of the
fucking floor.
No, I heard about that.
Hey, do you want to do something?
Babe, I'm on the phone with my friends.
But you've literally been talking to them for over 2 hours. When are we gonna actually hang out?
In a bit. Just give me a few more minutes.
Sorry, guys. What's up?
Earth to dipshit, your girlfriend is right there.
When did you get here?
I was in the clearance section at Macy's when I got a weird feeling, so I ditched my cart, stole some random lady's car, and got here as quick as I could.
Well, there's nothing wrong, so you can leave.
Oh, really? Bitch.
What was that for?
My bestie has been sitting here for how long now?
Over 2 hours.
Over 2 hours waiting for you to actually hang out with her.
I was just talking to some friends.
Bitch, if you wanted to talk to your friends for 2 hours, you should have just hung out with them instead.
I don't really see the problem, though.
The problem is my bestie's been wanting to talk to you, but you'd rather be talking to your friends in her company instead of talking to your girlfriend.
Okay, I see your point.
Now apologize to her and actually make use of your time here instead of being a waste of fucking space.
Okay, babe. I'm sorry, the conversation got carried away and I shouldn't have been ignoring you for that long.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Not you, bitch. I'm talking to my bestie.
You're welcome, girl. You two have fun.
I can't believe you did that.
It's really not that big of a deal.
You introduced me to your guy friends as your friend from school.
And?
I'm your girlfriend.
It's not that deep.
You dumb bitch.
Why are you here?
She texted me what you did, so I sprinted from across town and unlocked the front door with a stick I sharpened on the way here.
Well, if she told you, you know it's not that big of a deal.
Not that big of a deal? You chose to introduce your girlfriend as a friend from school.
And?
Bestie, can I slap some sense into him?
Mm-hmm.
Ow!
Ow!
Oh, did that hurt?
Good, because that's the pain she felt when you refused to introduce her as your girlfriend in front of your friends.
Okay, I'm sorry, babe.
No, I've had enough.
What are you saying?
We're over.
Yes! Finally, holy shit!
What does that even mean?
It means get the fuck out, you weird-ass bitch!
Fine, I have other girls I've been hooking up with anyways.
Don't be upset.
Why? I just broke up with my boyfriend and he admitted to cheating on me.
I know, but if it makes you feel any better, I did release a rattlesnake in his car before I came here.
I love you.
Bitch, you know I got you.
Ah, bitch, guess what day it is?
It's 420, bitch.
Now, I'm not making this video with the intent of promoting certain recreational activities. I'm making this video to tell all of you that there is a chance I may be partaking in some recreational activities. Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome.
If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is.
It's time for the daily scream.
I don't want my video to get removed,
so I'm saying all of this in a hypothetical sense.
Today, I might be hanging out with my friend Mary Jane,
and we also might be packing our bowls full of our favorite cereal brand,
Zaza.
Now, I know what some of you guys must be thinking.
But Spencer, partaking in these activities are bad for you.
And to that I say, with peace and love...
Shut the fuck up!
Love you all dearly. However, I don't think God intended on putting such a wonderful plant on this earth that he didn't want us to recreationally indulge in from time to time. And to that I say...
Happy 420, bitches!
This is me promising myself I am not going out tonight, and let's see if I uphold that promise. Now, reporting live from the scene, we have Steve with one of the abductee's acquaintances. Take it away, Steve.
How are you related to the person who's been kidnapped?
First of all, I'm not just an acquaintance. The bitch who got kidnapped is my best friend.
Okay, when was the last time you saw her?
Oh, that's actually a funny story because we lied and told her mom we were going to be studying at my house, but instead we got fucked up at some random frat party.
Can you identify what the victim was wearing?
How could I forget? I told her to wear these really cute low-rise jeans with a crop top, and she was all like, if we're going to a fraternity, we have to dress all slutty. So she ended up wearing a mini skirt with a simple crop top and some cute cowgirl boots.
Lastly, do you remember where she might have gone after this party?
Oh, I have no clue. We were so fucked up, but what I will say is that bitch is crazy. She did like 20 shots in a row and then shotgunned a White Claw. After that, I have no idea where she went.
All right, everyone.
Yeah, there no, you have I'm it. Not done. And to the son of a bitch who kidnapped my best friend, I swear to God, if you lay a single fucking finger on her, I will hunt you down to the ends of the earth and kill you myself.
Okie doke, back to you guys in the studio.
Yesterday, a teenage girl by the name of Heather was kidnapped. Now reporting live at the scene, we have Ryan with the latest update.
You'd think that this is just an ordinary town, but what if I told you just yesterday, a girl by the name of Heather was kidnapped right here. With me, I have two of her friends to tell us more about it. Could you identify what the victim was wearing before she was kidnapped?
Yeah, she was wearing high-waisted jeans with a tube top.
Also, her mom doesn't know about this. Sorry, Mrs. Howard, but we all have matching tramp stamps.
That was supposed to be a secret. Her mom's literally gonna kill her.
That's if she isn't dead already.
Also, bitch, she's been kidnapped. They need as much information they can get.
Well, just in case she's watching, is there anything else you'd like to say to her?
Yeah, can we actually hold the mic?
I don't really think that's necessary.
Okay, Heather, we don't have a lot of time, so we're gonna try to fill you in as much as we can.
First of all, you know your boyfriend you ditched us for?
Yeah, well, you've literally been missing for a day, and that motherfucker is already dating that bitch we all hate, Ashley.
Well, she's been going around school telling everyone that you guys are best friends.
Yeah, so I confronted Ashley in the hallway at school, and I was like, stop lying about being Heather's best friend, you clout-chasing ass bitch. And then I slammed her head into a locker.
Also, to the sick wench that kidnapped Heather, we're gonna find you.
Yeah, and when we do, I'm gonna shove my fist so far up your...
Top story this morning. Two individuals were caught vandalizing a teenage boy's car. With the culprits now, we have Steve with additional updates. This morning at around 3:00, two individuals were caught lurking outside teenager John Hayworth's home. What they were doing, you may be wondering? Spray painting and vandalizing his car.
Now tell me, what were you two thinking?
I was thinking one thing and one thing only.
Fuck that bitch for cheating on my bestie, and I'd do this shit all over again if I had to.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna have to ask the both of you to refrain from cussing and remind you that this is live television.
Wait, this is live?
Yeah.
I bet your dumbass of a cheating ex, John, is watching right now.
You thinking what I'm thinking?
Give me the mic. Hey, John Hayworth, remember me? I'm best friends with the girl you decided to cheat on.
No one cheats on my bestie and gets away with it.
We're limited for time because this is live and on the air, but we've decided to tell the general public some facts about you, John.
Hey, John, what's it like not knowing how to wash between your ass crack?
He has streaks in his underwear.
And remember that time you cried while watching My Little Pony?
And if I ever catch you in public, John, I'm gonna take both of my fingers and...
Bitch!
Guess who I met last night?
The one, the only... Chloe fucking Cherry!
That's right, bitch. I met Faye from Euphoria!
Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome!
If you're not new, you know fuck-ass time it is, bitch!
It's time for the Daily Scream!
So yeah, last night, I didn't get a photo with Chloe,
but I did see her perform a DJ set live!
she was giving. Like, the entire set, it was fucking giving.
Now, even though I don't have a photo with her, I did talk to her backstage.
And when I saw her, you wanna know what she said to me?
She said, oh my god, I know you. I love your TikTok.
Bitch, what?
I ended up talking to her for like 2 minutes, and she's probably one of the sweetest, most down-to-earth people I've ever met. There were so many people approaching her, asking her for photos, and she was literally so nice to everyone. That bitch is a 10 out of 10. But yeah, I met Chloe fucking Terry.
Social media is chipping away my mental health.
Like, it's tearing me down. It is tearing me down.
Tell me why I just checked my tags and mentions.
Someone
somebody commented on a video.
Someone tagged me in one of those genius videos where artists will explain their lyrics. I don't know the artist's name who was being interviewed, but someone literally tagged me and said, no offense, but you kind of look like at Spensois. Sorry. You mean to tell me you just told some random bitch that they look like me and apologize?
No.
What?
No offense?
You said no offense like it should be taken as an insult.
What the fuck?
I can only take so much.
This video goes out to the weird ass bitch who sold my friend a broken ass fucking car
and claimed that it only had 100 miles on it.
Bitch, fuck you.
Because you blatantly lied while selling my friend her car.
It stalled on the road 2 days ago. The wheel locked and me and my friends got into a fucking car accident, you dumb bitch.
Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome.
If you're not, you know, fuck ass fucking type of this bitch.
It's time for the daily scream.
So yeah, the other day my friend was driving her car.
Now, I don't know who sold my friend this car, but about 2 days ago, we were driving to her Airbnb from my apartment. My friend was driving and all of a sudden the wheel locked. And my friend was like, I don't know what to do, guys. Guys, the brake isn't working. The wheel's locked. And we hit like the back right corner of the person's car in front of us. Luckily, we're all okay. But I want to know who sold my friend this fucking car. Because how the fuck does a brand new car that only has 100 miles on it stall and cause an accident, you weird ass fucking bitch?
Hey.
Hi.
Aw, sweetie, what's wrong?
I know you're out of town, but my boyfriend just broke up with me, and I could just really use someone to talk to right now.
Hello?
I'm here.
What? How did you get here so fast?
I got in my car and drove as quickly as I could. I hit a few speed bumps on the way here, though, and lost my front bumper.
You didn't have to do that.
Bitch, don't start with me. I brought your favorite wine, your favorite movie, and I also brought some brownie mix so we can make brownies together.
But why are you doing all this? We could have just talked on the phone.
I don't want you to be alone. You should be with people who love you in times like this. Besides, why did you guys break up?
Turns out he had a girlfriend the whole time we were together, and they were just on a break.
So they were on a break for 7 months?
I guess so.
Well, at least I don't feel bad anymore.
Feel bad? About what?
Remember when I told you I hit a few speed bumps on the way here?
Yeah.
One of the speed bumps was your ex-boyfriend.
You didn't.
Yeah, we should probably call someone to tow my car to the scrapyard to dispose of all the evidence.
I love you.
I love you too. Now, let's watch The Little Vampire and make some brownies.
Do not fuck with me!
Last night I was at a club with a few of my friends. We were in a section, and these grown-ass, whack-ass men were blatantly making homophobic jokes about me in front of me!
Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome!
If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch!
It's time for the daily scream!
Last night I went to a club with my friends, there were some grown-ass men in our section, God knows why. But these motherfuckers kept looking at me and laughing, and I had enough! Eventually, one of my girlfriends, who all of these men were clearly interested in, looked at one of the guys and said, what's so funny? And then the guy was like,
oh, we're just joking, no harm here.
This man then went to give me a handshake. Bitch, thank God I have an uncle who was in the Navy, because growing up, he taught me how to give someone a proper handshake. Bitch, I quite literally grabbed this man's hand and applied pressure on one of the pressure points on his hand and just squeezed and would not let go. The man ended up pulling his hand away from me and was just sat there like this. I hurt your hand? I was just joking.
Don't fuck with me, bitch!
You're the dumbest bitch and with the biggest heart. I love that.
Hey, why are you crying?
Jack sent me a paragraph this morning saying that he thinks we should see other people.
Jack? But you told me you blocked him the last time he did this.
Ooh, uh-oh.
Bitch, are you dumb?
He said he would change.
Bitch, he barely changes his underwear. What makes you think he has the capacity to change into a decent person?
I don't know.
Bestie, give me your phone.
But—
Phone now! What are you doing?
Blocking him.
But
nothing, bitch. Stop giving shitty men the benefit of the doubt. You won't receive anything better if you keep accepting the bare minimum.
You're right. I just can't believe I was dumb enough to actually let him back in again.
You're not dumb for having feelings. You want to know what's dumb?
What?
Jack leaving his car unlocked because now he has a nest of killer hornets underneath his driver's seat when he gets up to go to work.
How did you?
No more questions. Let's just spend the day, me and you. I'll take you out and I'll show you how you should be treated.
Bestie, I love you.
I love you too. I'll be waiting out here whenever you're ready to go.
Okay, well, that's interesting. You know why?
Why?
Because... Okay, well, that's interesting. You know why?
Why?
Because...
So, I may or may not be talking to someone!
And to make a really long story short, I hung out with him the other night!
But! I've learned I'd rather be crazy right off the bat than act like a normal human being. That way, when I'm talking to guys, they actually know what they're getting into. And this man, everyone!
Hi, everyone, if you're new, welcome!
You're not needing all fucking time in this bitch!
It's time for the Daily Scream!
So the other night, I was debating whether or not I was gonna go out with my friends. But this guy I've been talking to for a little over a month told me he would meet me if I went out. Obviously, I ended up going out! But when I told him where I was, he was like,
I don't know if I'm gonna come out tonight.
Now, I was already out with my friends, but I was kind of pissed he was bailing on the plans he made. So in response, I messaged him back saying this. That's okay, it's my fault for assuming that you're actually the kind of guy to follow through with the plans they make. But just know, moving forward, I will not be going out of my way to see you again. Have a good night! You know what he messaged me back? On my way, coming right now! Next thing I know, he's there. We're talking. And we went from talking to kissing! Bitch, like...
This guy just DM'd me on Instagram calling me an ugly bitch. What do I even say back to that? Can I see that real quick? What are you saying? Don't worry, I'll let you see it before I send it. Okay. And here you go. You wanna talk about looks, you weird ass bitch? Let's talk about that receding hairline. You could land a large aircraft on that citadome you call a head. Is your mother proud of the whack ass 33-year-old man she raised, who still lives in our basement with Cheeto dust stained fingertips? I'm sure if you went to the zoo, people would think you're the main attraction because you don't even look remotely human. You look like Godzilla and King Kong had a child and then tossed it off a 20th story balcony. Wait, what are these random numbers?
Coordinates.
Of?
His location.
How did you-
Because no one fucks with my bestie and gets away with it, so are you gonna send the message or no?
You know, I think I'm just gonna block him.
Okay, then I'll just send a message myself.
Yeah, you do that. Only MC.
Even begin.
Some of you fucking Uber drivers
should not be fucking Uber drivers.
Now, you might not care about your life and your well-being, but as your passenger, I do, you crazy ass bitch. Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome. If you're not new, you know fucking term. It's time for the fuck ass Daily Scream. So this morning I booked myself an Uber to go to an in-person meeting. I would have driven myself, but lo and behold, the place I was going to had no fucking parking. So I get the Uber, I get in this guy's car, this motherfucker picks me up, and when I tell, oh my fucking God! Guys, I can't even make this shit up. When driving, this motherfucker would slam on the gas, literally floor it, and then we'd like go a few yards down the road, and he'd slam on the brakes! Bitch, this is what I looked like my entire ride to my meeting. I don't know what the fuck was wrong with this man. But when I tell you I would have literally flown out of the windshield if I wasn't wearing a seatbelt. Like, why are you an Uber driver, you dumb fucking bitch?
What happened?
You know that guy I was talking to?
Yeah?
He said he was gonna leak my pictures online if I didn't sleep with him.
One second, bestie.
Where are you going?
You'll see, sweetie.
Who the fuck are you?
Your worst fucking nightmare, you fucking pig!
What are you doing? Oh no, get away from me!
Don't you ever talk to my bestie again! Where is it?
Where's what?
Your phone, you stupid prick!
Here, take it, take it!
I got it!
Thank you so fucking much.
Oh, we're not done.
What?
We're gonna smash his phone to bits as a nice fuck you gift when we hand him back his phone.
You're the best.
No, bitch, you're the best. And that's why I'm not gonna let some piece of shit threaten you.
I call hammering his phone first.
Duh.
So last night I went out with a few friends and guys. I don't know what I drank last night that caused my stomach to turn inside out and then fight itself.
But this morning, bitch,
when I was on the toilet,
I was fighting for my fucking life.
Everyone, if you're new, welcome.
If you're not new, you know, fuck ass fucking time it is, bitch.
It's time for the Daily Scream.
So last night I went out with a few friends.
We drank.
We were at a club.
Now, I don't know what my friends were putting in these drinks,
but it had to be fucking laxatives.
Because this morning I felt like me and my toilet were at war.
You know in the movies when there's a massive flood? Like this. Or this. Or even this. Well, those are prime examples.
Of me in my fucking bathroom this morning.
I feel like I'm being punished by God.
Please, God, spare me!
I just got my grade back for my research paper.
It has to be good. You spent all year working on
it. What the fuck?
What is it?
I got a D and my professor left me a note saying I'm incompetent.
But there's no way.
I told you my professor hated me.
Let me see your laptop. What are you doing?
I'm sending your professor an email.
Please don't say anything mean.
I won't.
Just don't say anything that will make him drop my grade any lower.
Would you calm down?
Here you go.
Dear Professor Fredrickson, I saw that after giving me a D on my research paper, you left a comment calling me incompetent. I would just like to let you know that if anyone is incompetent, it's you. You wouldn't know what intelligence was if it bit you in the ass. I'm assuming you're bitter because your wife left you, but it's not her fault that your bald cranium nearly blinded her. I mean, seriously. Holy fuck. Maybe that's why you're so bitter. Your wife left you, you're bald, you're all alone, and you hate that I still have something you don't. A future. Furthermore, I hope you don't mind, but I've edited a picture of your head on top of this donkey's ass, because that's what you are. An ass.
How do you like it?
I think I'll just email the dean and send in a complaint about him.
Okay, are you sure you don't want me to try and write
something? No, I'm good. So recently I've been hosting talent shows on my TikTok live, and I just have one thing to say to all of you. You bitches are fucking sick and deranged!
Tell me why I had a guest on my live for the Daily Talent Show.
And instead of having a talent, they decided to show an explicit picture of Mario!
Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome!
If you're not, you know,
fucking dumb it is, bitch!
It's time for the Daily Scream!
So yeah, I've been having Daily Talent Shows on TikTok live. And some of you bitches need to be sedated and put in a straitjacket.
Cause what the fuck is this?!
Now, obviously, I had to blur out the photo, but someone quite literally joined my live and then had an explicit photo of Mario as their green screen. And for anyone wondering how I reacted during all of this, someone screen recorded my live, and I'm just gonna let it speak for itself.
Now we're on to the next person.
I can't.
Oh! Do you bitches want me to lose my account?
If I end up losing my account because of you fucking bitches, I swear to fuck.
What the fuck?
When I found out the Met Gala was yesterday, I genuinely thought we already had it this year. Like, the Met Gala happened 3 times this year and no one can tell me otherwise. But since we're on the topic, we might as well just rate the Met Gala outfits from yesterday. Before I get started, let me just clarify. I quite literally don't even know what the theme for the Met Gala was yesterday, so everything that's about to come out of my mouth should be taken very lightly. First up, we have Pete Davidson.
I'm sorry, but what the fuck is this?
Bitch, you're wearing a bucket hat and a trench coat. You know what? Let me not even speak on that because I guarantee that bucket hat and trench coat cost more than my entire life. Next up, we have Kim K. I think Kim K looks beautiful. I would have liked it if the pearls went all the way down. However, considering Kim is known for her Skims line and like tight fit wear, I think this is on brand for her and I like it. Next up, we have Jared Leto. Jared, I'm gonna try to level with you here. What the fuck is this? I feel like this could be the cover of Cats the Musical live on Broadway. Next up, we have Billie Eilish. I feel like Billie looks fucking amazing. But in that same breath, I would also like to add on Billie Eilish could have shown up to the Met Gala in a potato sack and I would still think she looked good.
Okay, bitches, I'm back again with more Met Gala ratings.
I'd just like to reiterate that I quite literally have no fashion sense, so everything that's about to come out of my mouth should be taken with a grain of salt. First up, we have Lil Nas X. Now I'm gonna be fairly honest. I think it's a really cool outfit. I think it's really extravagant. But if anything has convinced me that we're currently living in the modern day Hunger Games, it was this outfit. Like, all these bitches at the Met Gala, they're the people who live in the Capitol, and everybody else, yeah, we're tributes. Next, we have Janelle Monáe.
Now, I think the outfit is definitely something.
Then again, what the fuck do I know about fashion?
But bitch, try to convince me otherwise that she is not giving Effie Trinket from the Hunger Games.
Like, if you slapped the picture of her at the Met Gala on a Hunger Games poster, where's the fucking difference? Now we're on to Anne Hathaway.
Now, Anne.
Miss Hathaway! You ate the girls up this year. You really showed these bitches how it's done, and I'd hate to be the bitch that stood behind you on the red carpet. If I was at the Met Gala and I saw Anne Hathaway in front of me, I'd turn my ass around because there is no way anyone looked good while standing next to her. Now we have Doja Cat, and bitch, this is what Jared Leto should have been doing instead of wearing that fucking cat suit.
Come on, pick up. We have an emergency.
No, did Beyonce die?
No, not that kind of emergency.
Oh, what's wrong?
I accidentally liked my ex's Instagram post from 2 years ago, and I'm afraid he's gonna see.
Why are you stalking your ex's socials?
I do it when I'm bored sometimes.
Bitch.
Hello?
Okay, I got the fucking phone.
What? How did you get his phone?
I went to his job, pulled the fire alarm, and while everyone was running out of the building, I went into his office and stole his phone.
Well, what are we supposed to do with it?
Bitch, delete the notification so he doesn't see.
But I don't know his password.
Do I have to do fucking everything?
What is that?
Don't ask. All you need to know is that his phone is now unlocked, and the notification is now deleted.
Whew, that was a close one.
Tell me about it. I almost kidnapped his grandma, so he'd be more concerned with his nana missing than you liking an Instagram post from 2 years ago. I'm just glad I didn't have to come to that.
Me too.
So last night, it was my friend's 21st birthday. I got super fucked up with him. I had a great time. However, I don't remember getting home. And I just woke up this morning in bed like, what the fuck happened last night when I got home? I went into my kitchen this morning and I saw a trail of cheese on the ground. I need to fucking show you because it's actually like I was leaving breadcrumbs for myself in the morning to just know exactly where I went.
We start off in the kitchen and we have little cheese crumbs in front of the fridge. Keep going. Oh, look, more cheese crumbs. Some more crumbs over there. You get over here to my couch. There's cheese all over the ground, all here, okay? Okay. Then I was like, let me go into my room.
Why the fuck is there a bowl of cheese and a spoon next to my bed?
This guy from the club won't stop calling me and he's acting really fucking weird. You gave a random guy your number? Have you not seen the show, you? I was tipsy and I didn't think he'd be this crazy. See, he's calling again.
Hand me the phone. The person you're trying to reach just died. Sorry.
Why did you just tell a random guy that I'm dead?
So he'd stop calling? Well, clearly that didn't work. Hello?
Yo, stop playing with me. Come have fun at my place.
The only fun you'll be getting is from your own hand, because there is no way in hell she's coming over to your place. Do you know how weird you have to be to call a number 12 consecutive times in a row? Like, Jesus fucking Christ, get a grip.
I know you want this.
You wanna know what I really want? I wanna shove both of my fucking fingers into your eye sockets, switch them around, and look for a fucking brain, because clearly, you don't know how to take a fucking hint. I wanna take my fist and shove it so far up your ass that you can taste my knuckles on the back of your throat. If I could, I would find a massive tree branch, take it, and shove it right up your... He hung up.
Thank you so much for doing that.
Don't sweat it. I'm kind of hoping he calls back though, because I really want to finish my sentence.
Do you want his number?
Give it to me. Some of you bitches really need to learn what is and what is not a fucking joke. Because last night it was my friend's 21st birthday, and as a rite of passage, we took him to a club. But tell me why some bitch thought it would be hilarious to lie to my friend. Actually, you know what? Let me get this over with.
Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome!
You're not, you know, fuck ass fucking time it is, bitch!
It's time for the Daily Scream!
Some bitch thought it would be hilarious to tell my friend that I was getting roofied.
Who the fuck jokes about that?
Long story short, these two guys came into the club. One was talking to my friend, one was talking to me. And as I'm talking to this guy, he offered me a sip of his drink. And my friend literally ran over and pushed the drink out of this man's hand. Now, I wasn't gonna accept the offer anyways, but I looked at my friend and I was like, what was that about? And he tells me that while I was talking to this one guy, his friend looked at him and was like,
oh yeah, my buddy over there, he's roofing your friend.
But then after my friend knocked the drink out of his hand, the other guy was like,
hey, it was just a joke, it was just a joke.
But me and my friend were like, hi.
That's not a joke!
Like, who just says that for shits and giggles? Some of you bitches just
get on my fucking nerves!
Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know what fuck-ass fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the fuck-ass Daily Scream!
You guys wanna know what I'm really sick and tired of?
Guys playing fucking games with me!
Make up
your fucking mind, bitch!
Do you want a relationship or do you not want a relationship? Turns out this motherfucker, after literally telling me he wanted a relationship, turns around and says, oh, by the way, I don't want to lead you on or anything, but like, I really don't want a relationship right now.
Bitch, what? You reached out to me, first of all. Second of all, I'm the one who told you I didn't want a relationship. And now all of a sudden, after telling me, oh yeah, I want a relationship. And I was like, nah, let's just keep it casual for right now. Let me get to know you. Now all of a sudden, you're like, oh, I don't want a relationship. Make up your goddamn mind. Do I look like a Monopoly fucking game to you, bitch? Do I look like Jenga?
No, I'm not a fucking game. So stop treating me like one.
chest and my little frame and my sweet little girl voice. It exudes something in people that is extremely passionate and tantalizing, and I swear to God, all your men fantasize about me and probably wonder what it's like to be with someone who is as small as I am.
Guys, my body is in fucking pain! And I recently found out that the reason my body is in pain is because I've been following a workout routine meant for professional bodybuilders! Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! If you're not, you know, fuck ass fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily Scream! So if you guys didn't know, I've been going to the gym pretty consistently. Or at least I try to. I have a nutritionist, I fucking love him. But he sent me a nutrition plan and a workout plan, so I've just been following those. And yesterday was my leg day, and when I woke up this morning...
Bitch, I couldn't fucking walk!
So I messaged my nutritionist and I was like, hey, that workout plan you gave me is like actually killing me. And then he was like,
what workout plan?
So I sent him a screenshot of the workout plan he sent me, and bitch, the workout routines that he sent me were just meant to be examples. Guys, my body is in fucking pain! And I recently found out that the reason my body is in pain is because I've been following a workout routine meant for professional bodybuilders! Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! You're not, you know, fuck ass fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily Scream!
Bestie, what's wrong?
Some guy.
What do you mean a guy? Bestie, you're always giving people advice. We don't cry over men.
It's different.
What do you mean it's different?
I don't know. It's just easier to give people advice than it is to actually take it.
Give me your phone. Let me see him. Bestie, he's a 2 and you're a 12. 12s don't cry over 2s. It doesn't make sense.
But I really like him.
How long have you guys been talking?
A week.
A week? Bestie, 7 days only and you're already crying?
I know, it's sickening.
Does he give you attention?
Sometimes.
What do you mean sometimes?
He never texts me during the day, but he always texts me after 10 p.m.
Booty call hour? You don't see anything wrong with that?
I don't know.
So I'm gonna repeat back to you exactly what you just said to me, but like, I want you to give me advice. I'm sitting in bed crying over a man that only texts me at 10 p.m. and I've only known him for 7 days. What should I do?
I would tell you that you fucking deserve better and to drop him because he's a waste of fucking space.
Great, I'm glad we're on the same page, so I'm gonna do you a favor. I'm gonna block him.
But
it's non-negotiable, bestie. You'll thank me later. I'm taking this for now.